Hi, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bona and today I'm making red velvet cake. Yes, it is yummy and gorgeous looking cake. And the best part is it's going to be an eggless. Make your family events special with this unique and great looking red velvet cake. Perfect for Christmas party or the holiday events. Or make it heart-shaped for your special Valentine's Day. So let's start. So the first, I'm gonna start beating. I have the 2 sticks of butter. This is 1 cup and 1/2 pound of butter. And to that, 2 cups of sugar, the granulated sugar. Make sure everything is room temperature. This butter I have is room temperature. So 2 cups of sugar, beat very well. All right, so this is beaten very well. I'm gonna put it on the side right now. Now I'm going to work on the dry ends. This is the 3 cups of cake flour. Don't have a cake flour? Here is the easiest recipe that you can make your own cake flour in your own home kitchen. To that, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. Now when you use a baking soda, be very careful. If you overpower with the baking soda, then the cake will taste like something else. So be very careful when you add the baking soda to your baking recipes. To replace the baking soda, you have to add 3 times baking powder more than what the recipe calls for. So if, let's say if the recipe calls for 1 teaspoon baking soda, you have to add 3 teaspoons of baking powder, 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder, and the egg replacer. This is the energy egg replacer, 3 tablespoons. If you don't have energy egg replacer, here are some other suggested egg replacers. Mix all dry ingredients very well. So blend dry ingredients very well. Look at this, the color already got the cocoa powder color. All right. I have blended the butter and sugar very well and the dry ingredients are incorporated very well. So everything is ready to blend together now. But before that, what I want to talk about is the buttermilk. If you can't find the buttermilk, it's very easy to make at home in your own home kitchen. The buttermilk, you can make it at home. What you have to do is you take the 1 tablespoon of lime juice or vinegar and fill the cup with the milk up to 1 cup and let it stand on the counter for about 10 minutes undisturbed, and that will make 1 cup of buttermilk. So that's easy, huh? Now since I have this 1 cup of buttermilk ready, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add alternatively flour, this dry ingredients mix, and the buttermilk into this sugar and the butter mixture. So first flour, I'm gonna divide into 3 batches. So the flour and buttermilk and beat very well. The second batch of the dry ingredients, buttermilk again blend, and the last batch and the last buttermilk. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take water into this same cup. Since I added the egg replacer, I'm going to add water about 1/4 cup. That is it. But before that, we want to blend these things. Now I'm going to add this water slowly and keep blending. Now what I'm going to do is just a few more ingredients. I have this vinegar, the distilled white vinegar. I'm going to add 1 tablespoon. Now usually this vinegar is added to the baking soda and it foams up like a bubble up. And that's what you add into this bowl. But since I forgot and I added with all dry ingredients, the baking soda, so I'm gonna just add this vinegar now. 1 tablespoon, all right. And 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Now this, I'm just gonna eyeball. It says 1/2 teaspoon, but I know what 1/2 teaspoon is. So just like that, just eyeball. Smells so good now. All right, so the final blend. Now, if the consistency is not the right for the batter, I mean, if because we are replacing the egg with a dry egg replacer, sometimes you have to add more liquid to get the consistency of the right batter. Now, sometimes you can add milk, water. Now, in this case, I added the buttermilk. So I'm gonna add just a little bit of more buttermilk. So recipe calls for 1 cup of buttermilk, but then I can add 1 1/4 cup of buttermilk. So I'm just gonna eyeball here for the buttermilk. So 1/4 cup of more and blend again. All right, it looks perfect now. Now we are making the red velvet cake. So now it's time to add the color. And I have my gloves on because I'm gonna work with the color now. So I have the food coloring, the red color. I'm gonna add that now into the bowl here. And I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of color. The oven is ready, 350 degrees Fahrenheit, preheated. So 2 tablespoons, 1 and 2. Now be careful when you blend. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna mix a little bit with the spatula first, just to incorporate a little bit the color. Now I'm gonna use the blender to blend very well. All right, so the batter is ready now. Now I'm going to spray lightly the trays with the cooking spray so the cake comes out right. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this cup measurement to fill the trays, and let's see how the color comes out, because sometimes it's hard to get the desired color of the cake even though you add the right color. So hopefully this works out nice for us. So the both trays ready to go into the oven, preheated oven, 350 degrees. All right, so we're gonna bake about 25 to 30 minutes, but you have to keep an eye on it. And now a few cupcakes. I'm going to fill the cupcakes, ready to go into the oven as well. Let's check the cake. The cake has been baking for about 25 minutes and it has, I can see the sides are already cut off. So I'm gonna check. The color has come in. I'm gonna insert the toothpick in the center. If it comes out clear, it has come out the clear, so the cake is done. These cakes are cooling down. I have here the cupcakes ready as well. And look at them, it looks like a velvet because the buttermilk actually helps us to make the cake velvety.